actually about 12 years. I had a breakthrough injury as well, so I'm very well experienced and able to tell people what the risks are and things like that.
Yeah.
And I've been teaching probably my whole life, pretty much, as part of the community in skateboarding. So we're going to go through what a skateboard is, first of all. It's good for everyone to know the difference between this, and this. The different size of wheels, the looseness of the trucks, the width of the board, all these things make a massive difference in your skating, the shoes you're wearing, everything.
Advanced,
good choice, good choice. Yeah. And so we'll go through that quickly first. So, just because I'm going to be saying these words, it's good for everyone to know. Deck. The bit of wood is the deck. Trucks?
Yeah.
Okay. What's this one? So these are the trucks. Yeah. And wheels. And a little bit on the inside of the bearings. So with the deck, we're talking about width. A bigger board, harder to flip, easier to land. We'll get you guys to flipping the board someday, I'm sure, but for now you don't have to worry too much about it. It just means you just got more space. So I've got you a bigger board today, because I kind of guess that you might need a bigger one. So that's absolutely fine. So that's yours for today. With the trucks, we have loose or tight trucks. So all it basically means is that loose trucks, easier to turn. So if your goal is to cruise down the street and look cool and go to the shops and in and out of people, you want loose trucks. And tight trucks, easier to flip your board. So when you're doing tricks, tight trucks are better. So cruising, loose trucks are the best. So they're nice and loose, you'll be able to go in and out.
These are loose, yeah? I thought they were tight.
No, they're pretty loose compared to what I would usually ride.
Yeah.
And then wheels. The things that you kind of need to be on the lookout for is hardness and softness and size. Now, these are standard, but if you were going to just cruise down the street, you would want big soft wheels. And the reason for that, we'll get into in a minute, but the risks are, in London especially, we have cracks, we have stones, we have sticks. You don't want to hit them, not with these sorts of wheels. Those ones as well, very small, very hard. So it's just what we're going to do today is go through what to look out for. Make sure that, so when you guys are skating on your own, that you think, I can take that stick on, and then what happens is it beats you every time. It beats me every time, it beats you guys every time. You go flying.
Just a little stick like that.
Little stick like that. I've nearly broken my collarbone just from a little
barely
stick like
see
that.
It.
Yeah.
One of my worst
yeah,
that
guy's walking a collarbone from a stick.
When I was younger, I'd jump off things that high, I'd be fine.
Yeah.
And then a little stone or stick like that would do. It's the way to it. So it's just getting you guys aware, and we'll get you on the board, and we'll get you confident to roll down the road. So let's start down there if you guys are ready. And I've got two helmets as well, which I have to insist, unless you want to sign a form to not wear it, which is absolutely fine. It's up to you.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Let's get started.
That's it. Look how far Pat's come already. It's alright, keep going.
Yeah.
It's fine.
So then lean towards me.
Comfortable now, innit? Huh? Confident now? Huh? Said you're confident now?
You're moving. Got some distance there. Be confident, don't worry.
get it, don't get frustrated, don't get annoyed.
So you're both regular, that's actually
makes it easier to teach if you're both the same, so that's great.
So just take
it in. So I said about the wrists. So this is good, it's a nice open space. Pretty smooth, it's not the smoothest, but the landing is not bad. Like that. Now what will happen is your wheel will just stop. If you're going at any sort of speed, and you'll see like a big line of like white chalk behind you while you've landed way over there. It just throws you off. So it's just being used to putting the head up every time. It's like on a bike, you know? Same thing. Some people will always get in your way. It's just you don't think you can stop, you just let them know you're there. You would think they can hear you because the wheels aren't quiet. But some people just say it doesn't matter, they'll still do it. Yeah, exactly. So that's pretty much everything. And dogs as well. Some dogs, it's weird actually, I've got a lesson tomorrow with a dog. It's the first report. Yeah. So she's a dog behavioural therapist and she wants her dog to not be afraid or attack skateboarders. So I'm just gonna skate a dog on a muzzle as it tries to attack me. So that's going to be a lot of fun. It's definitely a new experience.
It's different,
for me.
Yeah.
But the thing with dogs is you don't know how they're going to react. They either love skating or they hate it. So if you do see a dog, just try and give it enough space. Exactly, yeah. Okay, so this is going to be fun. Okay. So I said.
There's a dog.
Oh, yeah, there we go.
Because I can't do both, I should. That's a good thing
for me. Okay, so. A bit more seasons ready. So usually we start with pushing, but I think you can do that, right? So if we just push, we just farm and dodge. Thank you. comfortable because you've been doing it longer, so her stance is a bit more natural. Yeah. It's very normal what you're doing right now, which is to be tense and your legs are straight. You're like this on the board. You're lying
there. Let me take off my jacket.
Here we go.
It's the same. It's just a case of when you're stiff like that,
yeah.
All it takes is the smallest thing to knock your back. Stay with your legs loose, a nice like triangle stance like that. Relax your shoulders a bit. Yeah, that's it. And your front foot is a little bit more square. A little bit more. You don't want to be riding like that.
Don't want to.
Like that. That's your perfect stance.
Sorry.
And if you do hit something or you need to get off, it's less.
sense to try and get up. Knees bent, shoulders relaxed. So, if you want to try, possibly just, I would say cruise, so just small little movements here now while you're skating. Again, don't force it. If you force it, you'll probably want to come off the board or whatever, just step off. But just little movements, just let the board take you and get you to the end, or kind of drift it from side to side.
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle number one, number two, Kawabunga.
It's not Skate P anymore.
Skateboard P, not yet. I need to bring it back to the last name.
Wow, go on, Nick. Concentrate on more and doing it than the speed. You're trying to do it too fast. Just take time. That's it. See? Take time. Gonna come gym with me then, yeah? Get you ready. Wow, believe. That's it. Look how far Pat's come already. It's alright, keep going. Yeah. It's fine. Confident now? Huh? Said you're confident now? trying to catch up with your legs. Lean forward, legs. That's it. Put your weight into the front. That's it. Down there, by the bags. Next to my bag. Whoa. I was not expecting that. Come, Alex, what you got? You gotta keep my eye on him, you know, in case he ends up on his bum. That's it, that's it.
aiming towards.
I want to learn now. No, I'm joking. Don't want to break anything. Nope. Black my bones. Come on, let's see how smooth you are. How it's done.
Separately as well. Again, it's not a key skill, it's just something that will get you. The more you know about that sort of stuff, the more you're bored.
skateboard these days?
Something like this? That one especially would be about 150.
150, yeah?
Yeah, but you can buy a good complete like that one for 50 to 80 pounds.
£80.
Yeah.
So 50 to 80 or 150 for this?
Yeah, I would.
Because it's bigger or wider?
It's just the companies, that's more of like a premium thing. It's worth saying I run a skate shop as well, so 10% off for all learners.
You're going to give me the plug in the end, so
plug it away. But yeah, it just depends. Like, one of the things I do go through with learners, my lesson after this, she doesn't have a skateboard either, and she wants my advice on what to buy. Now, for a brand new learner, I'm not telling you to spend £150.
Yeah.
It doesn't need to happen, but you also don't want high-class quality goods either. So that kind of, we call it a Christmas complete, that's usually what kids get for a Christmas present or something like that. Usually about £80, you can get it from like the most recognisable brands and stuff like that, but the quality of the materials is just slightly lower, but that's fine if you're just learning. So all the biggest brands do. So look on any kind of skate website and they will have them for about, like I said, £60, £70, £80. So like this one in particular, very expensive, I'd say probably about £160, £170. And I'll probably break it for a little while, it's just the way it goes.
What, in the middle?
In the middle, yeah. I mean, I don't snap boards too often, but what can happen is there's just a lot that can go wrong. Skateboarding, you know, things happen. But to me, it's worth the investment because it's going to be all the time. So, might as well. So, what we'll do now then is, like I say, so we'll call it a turn, a 180, a switch, whatever you want to call it. So similar with a tic-tac. So what we want to do is maybe to start off with, just start tic-tacking. Have your arms out like this for balance. And start tic-tacking just slightly, but keep going in the same direction. Good. So the goal that we're going to try and do is get you to do like a half turn. As little movements as possible. So the key is, done it already with a bunch. Just try doing it with like one touch. What you want to do is stay leaning forwards. The common thing that happens is people try and over swing. Like that, I see it all the time. So you're going to need to stay your legs bent. Arms out. Like that. Give yourself a nice base. And yeah, there you go. Your chin go in the direction that you want to go as well.
Very close. Someone's very competitive.
Yeah, just about.
Ooh.
You want to use a line like this if you're kind of put your breath.
Yep, and then give your hands
to one legs.
Yeah. hips. Shoulders, yeah. Yeah, there we go.
Thank you.
She's beating you. Go on, Lex. Are you spitting, P?
Technically, I have a lesson in 5 minutes, but I'll wait for her to show up, so we can just keep going until she lets me know she's here.
Alright.
Have you tried ollies yet?
No. I've tried it before, but I've never really...
Okay. Too nervous.
I think for the last however long we have until turns up, I'd like to see some ollie attempts, and for you, just jumping on the board. So ollie is like that. So just made the first trick that everyone learns. But before that, sometimes it's better to, I mean, maybe we can try this as well first. It's just a little up on the board. So it can be dangerous. The board can slide out, which is why it's important. As always, make your legs stay nice and loose. What you want to do is land on your feet on the box. What can happen is if you're, there you go. If you land with your feet together, this is like anything. You land like that, the board will slide.
And I feel more nervous about doing this
is a trick. Yeah, do it once at a time first. If you need to, just do that.
Yeah.
And that. Yeah. Well, whichever one that you feel more comfortable with. But remember, keep those legs bent. You don't want to, like I said, you don't want to land with your legs straight. You will fly up.
Nice trick.
Yeah. I can be there if you need it. No, shame in it at all. I'm sure I'll stand it. If you need to grab out. Nothing to. Alright, I'll be here just in case. There you go. So when you're landing, remember.
It's harder than it looks, guys. Harder than it looks.
When you're landing, just remember. Yeah. Land. Yeah. Never, no matter what you're doing. What level you're at in skating, you're going to land the
lecture. I'm impressed.
Getting these things too quickly for what I had planned. Okay, so let's focus on an ollie then. I think maybe we could ready to possibly go through it. So, what do you know already about ollies? Hit it, not jump, or they won't hit it, they will jump. or any combination of everything they're supposed to do, like just putting it all together at once.
Showing off now.
I'm so nervous.
It's a lot. It's, like I said, I've been doing this so long and teaching people so long. It's, always putting the things together at the right time, that's the problem.
Yes. Okay. So, don't rush yourself. You're doing this, you're getting ready. Up here. And then you go like that, you're picking it up. Stay low for as long as you need. Spring if you need to. Come up. Don't rush yourself.
Yeah. Is this where you'll be? You'll be booking another lesson?
So I do it here, you know, Meanwhile Gardens.
Okay, yeah, yeah. That's
like
right next to us.
Depends on the user's need, but I'd say for now, do it here until everyone's comfortable and then we'll go to the skate park.
Okay, sweet. Yeah. All right, thank you very much.
Stop it again, just to let him do a plug.
Okay.
So I can tell
you
are.
You want me to stop
let me,
it now?
Let me get a picture of you guys first. If you guys want to do this again, I'll be really keen. Great stuff.
So where can everyone find out?
Okay, so me, you can go to www.bestfootforwardskateacademy.com or you can find us on Instagram at bestfootskateacademy. If you do need to buy any skateboards, we do Bricktop Skate Shop, which is named after the character in Snatch. A great movie, you should watch that as well. That's it.
Thank you.
Alright, thanks guys. That was great. I hope to see you guys again. And I might bring an extra board and helmet.
Yeah, I'll definitely land on the floor. Thank you.
Yes guys, so we just finished our first skateboard lesson. This is Malika.
Hi.
This is my youngest self, who I'm teaching her how to skate now. Skateboard P and this is Skateboard M now. What did you think?
It was fun and I think
it got
better now.
Mm-hmm. You got some new stuff?
Mm-hmm.
What would you rate it out of 5?
Definitely a 5 out of 5.
5 out of 5?
Yeah.
Wow. That's a good score. To be fair, I think I'll give it about 4, maybe 4.5. Five, it's really good, man. If you're a novice beginner skater, Mark is definitely a good guy to come and teach you. Within like what, half an hour? Last time I skated was when I was 6 years old. So it's been like literally 30 years now. You can work out my age. 30 years since I picked up a skateboard, and within half an hour, I picked it up. Mark normally charges £15 for an hour lesson. So that's a one-on-one, or you can do it in a group session, and then an extra £5. For the skateboard, so if you haven't got a skateboard, we'll bring a skateboard for you, Sherry, and a helmet. So I'll put these details in the link in the bio. Don't forget to like and subscribe.